A brick wall from the IRS. House Oversight Committee Chairman Darrell Issa saying that the agency is stonewalling the investigation into the targeting of conservative groups. In a recent letter to Acting Commissioner Danny Werfel, Issa wrote this. This is a quote. The actions of the IRS under your leadership had made clear to the committee that the agency has no intention of complying completely or promptly with the committee's oversight efforts. David Drucker is senior correspondent for the Washington Examiner, and he joins us now. Thank you for joining us.
Good to be here, Heather.
So is the IRS stonewalling?
Well, I think part of this is the usual friction you have between the legislative branch and the executive branch, particularly when the parties are different and you have one side trying to get information and the other side sort of protective of its turf. But I think part of this could be that the administration changed its tact on the IRS situation. In the beginning, the president was outraged, and the argument was that clearly something wrong happened. It shouldn't have happened, but it wasn't political, and there was no political motivation behind it. And now what you're hearing from both the president and his aides are, this is a phony scandal that doesn't exist. And what you've heard from Democrats on the Hill is a transition from outrage, this shouldn't have happened, we hope it's not political, to it wasn't political at all, we know it's not political, progressive groups were also targeted. This, as Treasury Secretary Liu said on Fox News Sunday over the weekend, this was an equal opportunity problem. And so I think this is part and parcel of where the administration has gone with this in an effort to see this thing go away. And to a degree, it helps. Because instead of the argument over, we know something happened, was it political, it's now one side saying nothing happened and the other side saying it did.
And perhaps hoping if they say phony scandal enough, people will then believe it. But the bottom line is, you know, the agency, they have turned over 12,000 pages so far out of roughly 64 million pages that it deemed, you know, potentially relevant to the investigation. So how do you explain that?
Well, I explain it that the IRS doesn't want to help House Republicans who have subpoena power. Senate Republicans don't, but House Republicans do. They don't want to help them sort of conflate this in the media and potentially reveal problems or present a picture that there might have been problems. And one of the ways that you stop the opposition from doing that to you is not giving them the documents they want that might show that bad things happened, or might give them an opportunity to suggest bad things happen, even if they didn't. We've seen this before with other administrations and other Congresses, and so politically it really makes sense, because right now the public is not up in arms demanding as a whole that the administration release all of these documents. People are focused on other things. It's the middle of the summer. Mm-hmm. Jobs and the economy are still foremost in people's minds, and even though there was outrage, the heat on this has diminished, and there's no reason for the administration and the IRS to feed into what House Republicans want.
Well, there is some new information coming out, though, and that is that the IRS, even after granting tax-exempt status, at least three groups, including the Billy Graham Evangelistic Association, they continued to take a closer look at after the fact. So, you know, maybe that will develop into something as well. Thank you both, or thank you for joining us. We appreciate your insight.
Thanks a lot, Heather.
Thanks. There is a